training day. I'm Patty.
And I'm Sid. Today on the show, we'll be surprising five young up-and-coming athletes with an opportunity to train like an Olympian with some of this country's top coaches.
Not only that, they'll have a chance to meet their Olympic heroes.
So cool. And we'll be holding some of our own events right here in the studio. Are you guys ready for this?
Yeah! It's gonna be great. Don't go anywhere.
Kids CBC went to British Columbia to surprise up-and-coming BMXer, 11-year-old Diego.
This is Diego. Diego lives in Surrey, BC with his mom, dad, and two sisters, all of them BMXers. They live and breathe BMX, especially Diego. Diego has been racing since he was just 5 years old. He's one of the best in the world for his age division. Diego dreams of going pro and one day competing in the Olympics like his hero, Tory Nyhaug. And not only is Diego a great BMXer, he is also a great kid. Just ask his grandma.
He's just a sweet, kind, wonderful grandson.
So together with his mom, dad, sisters, aunt, cousin, grandparents, teammates, and his gorilla, Kid CBC arranged to surprise Diego with a day of expert BMX training.
He has no idea what's coming. He won't know what hit him.
He's probably gonna be like, ready?
Let's go.
Hey Diego, it's me, Tory Nyhaug. I'm here to tell you that you've been selected for Kids CBC Olympic Games Training Day. You get to spend the day training like an Olympic athlete with Adam Muse, who is a longtime friend and has been a BMX coach for many years. So he can give you some knowledge, and one day you can go to the Olympic Games as well. Have fun and work hard.
Okay then. I'm excited and I'm a little bit nervous. I still don't know what's happening right now.
Diego is off to train like an Olympian. First stop, the Richmond Olympic Oval.
Hi, I'm Adam Muse. I'm the National Development BMX coach. Right now, I'm just waiting for Diego to show up. We're gonna do some Olympic training today. All right, let's get started.
Awesome job today.
Thank you.
Now let's head to the track and see what you got.
Let's go.
Now we're out here in Abbotsford at the BMX track, and we're about ready to head up the Olympic start hill. Are you ready for this?
I think so, yeah.
I'm a little bit nervous right now because it's a pretty big hill. The biggest one that I've went down is 5 meters. This one is 8 meters. It's pretty big, so I'm gonna go down it now.
Thrill for me today is to see him go down that hill.
I feel really good and awesome.
I'm super stoked for the guy.
Great job, Diego, but we're not finished yet. Kid CBC still has one more surprise left. We arranged for Diego's hero, Olympian Tory Nyhaug, to meet him on the track.
This is gonna be good.
I've never seen like how high like Tory has to jump and how fast they'll go, and it's really cool.
What's up, Diego?
Oh, hey, Tory.
How's it going?
Good. I was talking about what happened today, and then out of nowhere, Tory came out, and I'm really excited now.
Good to see you, buddy. How was training this morning?
Good.
You okay if I ride with you today?
Yeah.
All right, cool.
Watch the gate.
Woo! When Tory came out, it was such a heartwarming feeling.
I think it really, really amped him up and
He's really stoked about this whole experience.
Diego, I'd like to wish you good luck in the rest of your BMX career. I hope you become an Olympian one day as well. There you go, man.
Now I know how hard Olympians have to train, but just from this experience, I now want it so much more than I did before. This was the best day ever.
Wow, what an awesome surprise. Okay, so I have some trivia. What's an Olympic event that you might go head over heels for?
Swimming?
Not the one I'm looking for.
Soccer?
That's pretty close.
Gymnastics.
All right, that's it. Okay, let's go over to Truro, Nova Scotia and meet another girl who's head over heels for gymnastics.
This is Lauren. Lauren lives with her mom and dad in Truro, Nova Scotia. Lauren has been practicing gymnastics since she was a toddler. After a lot of hard work and with a lot of support from her mom and dad, Lauren is now competing at the national level. The next step, the Olympics, like Lauren's hero, Ellie Black. So we went to Lauren's school and arranged for her to take a very special trip to the principal's office, Kids CBC style.
Hi, would you ask Lauren to come down to the office, please, to see Miss McLean?
Okay. Lauren, can you go to the office, please?
I'm Olympic gymnast Ellie Black, and I'm here to say that you've been selected for the Kids CBC Olympic Games Training Day. You get to train with my coach, David Kikuchi. So good luck and have fun.
When she walked through the door, she looked absolutely shocked.
I'm just very, very pleased and happy for her.
I'm going to be training with an Olympic coach, and I'm really excited and nervous.
Lauren is off to Halifax, where she will train at Ellie Black's gym with Ellie's coach, David Kikuchi.
Today with Lauren, we're going to do some warm-up and conditioning, some vaulting, some bars, and a little bit on the beam. Hi, Lauren.
Hi.
Welcome to Alta. I'm glad you're here today. Let's go get ready.
All right, Lauren, we're going to work on dismounts today.
That was one of our first times trying a double back, two flips in the tuck position, and those went really well.
When you think you're at about 1 3/4 flips, try and look for this mat.
At her gym, she doesn't have a foam pit like we have here.
Okay, good, you saw it better that time.
On beam, we're gonna practice back handspring layouts.
Awesome.
And dismounts, which is back handspring, full twist. Lauren, we're gonna work on your vaulting next.
Nice, pretty good. See if you can get a little bit faster. Seems like you're a little bit tired out. So yeah, take your time. All right, Lauren, let's see the pike.
Wow.
She did it.
Coach David is the best coach ever, and I'm so happy that I had this opportunity today.
Nice work, Lauren. Even our gorilla flipped out. But the best is still to come. Lauren's hero, Olympian Ellie Black, is about to make a surprise visit.
Go ahead.
So you have the national championships coming up at the end of next month. And that's your first one, and Ellie will be there. That'll be very, very exciting.
Hey! How's it going?
Ellie snuck up behind me, surprised me.
To meet her hero, it's just been an opportunity of a lifetime for her.
I'm excited to train with Ellie. I can't wait!
We're gonna take a couple of the parts of the routines and work on the dance and see if we can bring out some more smiling and chin up and long arms and really show off the routine because that's what the judges are gonna be looking for. Working on the floor dance, I think she's doing a great, great job, and she's a powerful gymnast, so it's great to see her doing so well.
I want to be like her someday.
Extend it, and have your chin up just a little bit more.
Nice and big, nice and sharp. Big ending. Awesome. Nice work.
That was awesome.
After training with the Olympian, I learned that it's really hard work, and I'm gonna train even harder now.
Amazing job today. Because you did so well, we have something for you that hopefully will remind you of everything that you learned today and all the great experiences. Lauren, I know you're gonna do great things in gymnastics, so keep working hard, and I know you'll achieve your dreams.
Today was amazing!
Wow, Lauren was really beaming. Balance beaming.
Let's see which one of our contestants is laughing after our next Kids CBC 2016 event.
This event is called Having a B-Ball. Now, contestants have to get as many baskets as possible in 1 minute, and they can only use their neck.
First to stick his neck out is Mitchell. All right, Mitchell, what is your favorite summer Olympic sport to watch?
Soccer.
Nice.
And Zaheen is ready to sink some baskets. What is your special technique?
Using the side of my neck.
Okay, get ready. 3, 2, 1, begin.
All right, cheer them on, guys.
How does it feel to be a champion, Mitchell?
Exciting.
Nicely done, you two.
Let's keep this ball rolling. 10-year-old Julia loves basketball, so when she meets two Olympic ballers, well, you'll see.
Meet Julia. Julia lives with her family in Toronto, Ontario. With a basketball coach dad, b-ball playing big brother, and supportive mom, Julia has been playing basketball since she could throw a ball.
For Julia, basketball is everything. She just loves it.
So with Julia at practice, we set up hidden cameras around her house and prepared for Julia to get a very special delivery, Kids CBC style.
Practice is wrapping up. I hope they're ready for us. She's gonna be so surprised.
CBC sent it to you. Open it.
Surprise!
Oh my God.
Check out this video.
Hi, I'm Tamara Tatham from the Canadian Women's National Basketball Team. And I'm here to tell you that you've been selected for the CBC Kids Olympic Games Training Day. You get to train with one of my coaches, Steve Bauer. Good luck and go Canada.
Oh my gosh. Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
I can't wait to start training.
All right. Woo, bye. Bye.
It's off to the Mattamy Athletic Center where Julia will meet her coach.
Hi, I'm Steve Bauer, coach with Canada Women's National Team, heading to the Olympics, Rio 2016.
Hey, Julia.
Hi.
I'm Steve. I'm gonna be your coach today.
Okay.
Are you excited?
Yes.
Okay, let's go.
Julie and I are gonna do some change of direction skills, some posting up, and some shooting, helping her with her balance. Hopefully when we're done, Julia's got a better sense of change of direction and enjoys her experience with Canada basketball.
Yes!
The drills are awesome, and I think I did very well. I'm very proud of myself.
Julia was amazing today. Working hard on the drills, getting better, it was a real pleasure for me.
Julia's training isn't over yet. Olympians Tamara Tatham and Lizanne Murphy are standing by for a surprise visit.
We're gonna go surprise Julia.
First things though, we're probably gonna need a few more people to play in the game.
Okay, Julia!
Nice
Nice to meet you. I'm Lizanne.
Hi, Lizanne.
Hi.
Tamara, nice to meet you. Looking like a baller.
When the Olympians came out, I was so excited. I was like all shaking and I was so nervous.
It was truly amazing watching Julia's reaction when the two Olympians came out. Priceless.
Right now, I feel like, oh yeah, oh yeah. I just went to Olympians, oh yeah, oh yeah.
Shoot to start, let's go. Yes! Let's go!
Too good, we're too good.
Screen coming, Liz. Screen coming, Liz. Okay.
In and out. Later, bro.
Hey! Shoot.
Not today, Julia. I'm
saying she
can
Okay. Oh, my
God. Oh. Hey! We're so excited.
We're so Great shot.
Okay, tie game. For all the glory.
Nice pass. Nice pass.
Julie did absolutely amazing. She did really, really well.
Yes, good teamwork.
So we had an amazing game with her. Of course I was on her team, and of course we won.
For a 10-year-old, she's got so much talent. I think she's got a great future in basketball. Don't move, you'll mess up our signature.
Julia, I wish you the best in your training. Continue to work hard, and I can only imagine how far you're gonna get later.
I had an amazing time. It was so much fun. Best day of my life.
You're ready for Team Canada.
Yeah, you're ready.
You're ready, you're ready.
That was a ball. Get it? Ball? Oh, a tough crowd. Okay. Now, who is your favorite Olympian of all time?
Donovan Bailey.
Nice choice. Now imagine having a chance to meet your hero. Well, swimmer Alexander had a chance to do just that.
Meet Alexander. Hailing from Toronto, Ontario, Alexander has always loved sports, especially swimming. And he's never let his cerebral palsy keep him out of the pool.
Swimming for Alexander has been a game changer for him. It's given him a whole new world of opportunity. It's given him freedom that he doesn't get to experience on a daily basis. He just loves it. He's like a fish.
So, with a little help from Paralympian Abi Tripp and her coach Vicky Keith, Kids CBC planned a day of next-level swim training. Now, to let Alexander in on our plan. We went to Alexander's school, and with help from his mom and his friends, we rigged up the classroom with hidden cameras and got ready for a kid CBC-sized surprise.
Alexander's downstairs right now in his cooking class. There's cameras hidden everywhere. He has no idea what's going on. He's gonna be so surprised.
He's coming, he's coming.
Kids CBC shows you!
For the Kids CBC Olympic Training Day. You'll be training with my coach, Vicky Keith, here in Kingston, Ontario. Congratulations and good luck.
And the last question. Why is there a gorilla in here?
I feel kind of happy. If you'll excuse me, my mommy has to take me to Kingston.
Alexander is off to Kingston, Ontario, home of Paralympian Abi Tripp, where Alexander will train with her coach, world record-holding marathon swimmer, Vicky Keith.
Are you Alexander?
Yeah.
It's nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
You ready to do some swimming?
Yeah.
Okay, let's head to the pool. We're really excited to have Alexander here today. He's ready to get in the water and show me what he's able to do. Then you're going to pull here, way up here, instead of down below. So keep your hands up forward. Ready? One, two, now roll over, head back. Head back, good job. Now swim on your back, swim on your back. High five.
But wait,
Kids CBC still has one more surprise. We arranged for Paralympian swimmer Abi Tripp to meet Alexander at the pool.
Hey guys, we're gonna go see Alexander. Let's go.
Do you know I have a Paralympic swimmer on my team? Yeah, her name is Abi Tripp, and you know what? She's sitting right beside you.
How are you?
I love Abi Tripp.
I was super excited when Abi Tripp came out because this truly gives something for Alexander to aspire to.
Thank you. How does it sound to come and join my practice today?
That's good.
Okay, let's do it.
Ready? Go!
Watching Alexander today was a very proud moment for me. I was so amazed by his tolerance and how well he did.
I love that making mistakes doesn't matter. You always try your best.
Alexander, I want you to remember that nothing is impossible.
Today was happy. And today was beautiful. And today was exciting.
I think that went swimmingly.
As do I, Patty, and I'm ready to dive into our next Kids CBC 2016 event.
This event is called Hurdling into the Unknown. In this event, our athlete must go over and under hurdles while blindfolded without making contact with any of the hurdles. And you know what, Sid? I think these guys have tried enough challenges. I think it's time for their principal to try it.
Heather, come join us. All right, Heather. So your students did an absolute amazing job. Are you ready for the challenge?
I think so.
Okay, so you see behind you, we have a blue hurdle, a red hurdle, and a yellow hurdle, okay? And what's gonna happen is you're gonna limbo under the first one, step over the second one, and wiggle like a worm under the last one. Except you're gonna do this blindfolded.
Okay.
Are you ready?
I think I'm ready. Am I ready?
Yeah! Hold this for me. Let me put the blindfold on.
Make sure she can't see anything.
Can you see anything?
No.
Okay.
Okay. So I'm going to explain this again just so it's really safe. So you're going to limbo underneath the first one. Then you're going to step over the second one, wiggle like a worm, but you can't touch any of them. Ready? Go!
Here on it. Ready?
Being such a great sport, Heather, you are an Olympian in my heart.
And speaking of Olympians, in our next surprise segment, a lucky young hurdler gets to train with Olympian Sekou Kaba. Watch. This is Anna. Anna lives in Ottawa, Ontario with her mom, dad, and brother.
Go Lions!
Anna has been running since she first learned how, and now she's a rising track and field star. And not such a bad big sister.
Anna's the best sister ever.
So we decided to take her training to the next level with Hurdler Sekou Kaba, representing Canada in Rio 2016. But first, we needed to let her in on the secret, Kids CBC style. So we hit up her school and rigged her class with hidden cameras. Then we hid in another room and waited. She's gonna be really surprised. While Anna got ready for lunch, we got ready for a gorilla-sized surprise.
Kids CBC chose you!
Hi Anna, I'm Olympic hurdler Sekou Kaba, and I wanted to let you know that Kids CBC has selected you for an Olympic training day with my Olympic coach, Andy. Congratulations and good luck.
Right now I feel really surprised and happy.
Anna is off to the Terry Fox Athletic Center to start her training with six-time Olympic coach, Andy McKinnis.
Hi. Hi. I'm Andy, and you are?
Anna.
Anna, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
I understand you are a wannabe hurdler. We're going to take you to the next level, get you ready for maybe not Rio this time, but maybe Tokyo, and who knows beyond that. Are you ready?
Yep, let's go.
Okay, let's go. We'll see how you handle this. Okay. On your marks, set. Run, run, awesome. Let's go at it. Now we're gonna add some steel and plastic to the event. Relax, good balance, set. Arms, one, two, three, four. She's got a natural aggressiveness and an affinity to hurdling, and hurdling, you need that in an athlete.
Coach Andy was really good at coaching. He taught me some things that I wouldn't have known.
But the training's not over. Someone very special is waiting to put Anna's new skills to the test. Sekou Kaba.
I want to go surprise Anna. Let's go.
It's an Olympic year, so why not take advantage of an Olympian, right?
Yeah.
I want to introduce you to the next step in your hurdling career. Sekou, this is Anna.
How you doing, Anna?
Oh, my gosh. Hi.
Good to meet you.
Good to meet you, too.
Thanks for coming out today. Well, what do you think of us hurdling?
Let's go.
Let's go for it.
The race is on and the stakes are high.
Throughout the training, she decided to moth off a little and wanted to race.
Since there's 10 hurdles in the Olympic hurdles,
right,
and you're 25 years old,
uh-oh,
25 times 10 is how many push-ups you'll do. And since I'm 12 years old, I'll do 12 push-ups if I lose.
That's not fair. That's cruel.
Well, that's how it goes.
So I made sure she did the push-ups. That 12 push-ups you have to do?
Yeah.
Real push-ups. That one doesn't count.
My race with Sekou. Well, I didn't win, but that's not what matters. What matters is that I tried. What I learned today is don't give up on your dreams, and you'll make it if you keep trying.
Anna, I wish you very well in everything that you do in life.
Woo! Seeing the smile on her face was nothing else a dad could ask for.
She made me very proud.
Anna, we wish you the best. I think you're a natural. Work hard, and dreams can come true.
Today was awesome. I loved track and field before, but now I want to run even more.
That was incredible. Thank you to all of our up-and-coming athletes, and a huge thank you to the Olympians for giving these kids the surprise of a lifetime.
That's right. We'll be cheering for you in Rio. In fact, to all our athletes of Rio 2016, we have something to say.
Go
Yeah. And of course, a big thank you to all of you guys for being here today and participating in our own Kids CBC 2016 Games.
You guys did so great. I think they all deserve gold medals. What do you think?
I think you're right. And here with your medals is CB.
Thanks for joining us. Bye, everybody.
Bye-bye. Bye.